Now, KSBW presents High School Playbook Blitz.
And welcome to Week 7 High School Playbook Blitz. Lots of games to get to. Let's start with the Battle of Unbeatens, 5-0 Seaside against 5-0 Monta Vista Christian. This game tonight played at Seaside High. And for, I got to be honest with you, for two of the high-powered offenses in the area, this is not a good beginning. Two of the high-powered offenses in the area, this is not good for our undefeated game. But we're going to stick with this. I tell you what, let's go to the next game and maybe we can come back to that. I will tell you, in case we don't get back to it, I will tell you that it was a Seaside 12-7. 12-7 Seaside in that game tonight. We don't have highlights. In that game over Monta Vista Christian. Okay, Salinas High Cowboys tonight taking on the Christopher Cougars in Gilroy. Christopher cheerleaders weren't looking as Salinas High punched it in right here. Jordan Torres takes it in for the Cowboy touchdown. And then we're going to see the Salinas defense in action. Vince LaSala with a pick six for the Cowboys. Interception return for a touchdown. Vince LaSala and Salinas High would win this game handily. But there were some plays made by the Christopher Cougars. Right here, Zach Olmash. Great return. 41-yard return by Zach Olmash. That would lead to this touchdown, and you want to check out this touchdown. Quarterback keeper Sterling Montgomery goes up and over Marcus Castro and in. Actually, a good play by both guys, Marcus Castro and Sterling Montgomery, up and in. The effort, though, right here, touchdown, Salinas High. Jordan Torres, possible play of the week, Jordan Torres, Salinas High. 55 yards and the touchdown. Salinas High rolls in this game. Salinas High looking really like one of the better teams in this area now. Cowboys 50-16 over Christopher High. Another big win for Salinas High next week when they take on Monterey High at the Pit. Speaking of Monterey High, those Toreadors from Monterey against the Haybalers of Hollister tonight. Monterey in the green tops. Good job here by Monterey defense. James Hill, one of those in on the tackle right here. James Hill, one of those guys who plays offense and defense. Rugged, hard-hitting game. Some hard-earned yards here by Ambrose Navarez of the Doors. And then it's the previously mentioned James Hill third, the Monterey quarterback. Nice pass, Anthony Arzandan. Big gainer for Monterey High right there. But also lots of great defense in this game. Monterey would put up 28 points, and Monterey is a winner. This is the first time in 14 years that Monterey High has beaten the Haybalers. Let's go to our next game. Soledad Aztecs home against the Gonzales High Spartans. Soledad looking for their fourth win of the season. And they're going to get a touchdown right here. Frankie Martinez, number 11, coming right at you, going right by you, into the end zone. Touchdown, Frankie Martinez of Soledad. Next score for Soledad. Touchdown pass, Fernando Longoria, hooking up with Joseph Castillo. Soledad, really good-looking team this season. I like Soledad High. They are a strong team. Check out the next play, though, for Gonzales High. Possible play of the week, maybe. The pass is tipped by the defender, caught by Rhett Panzera. And guess what? He's gone for a Gonzales touchdown. Heads-up play. They didn't win, but that was a great play. It was a walk-away win for Soledad High. 43-28 is the final. Now let's go over to the Del Monte Forest and Pacific Grove High School. Breakers from PG taking on Marina High. Marina High looking for their first win. Not a lot of highlights for the Breakers, but a nice effort here. Xavier Schwinner, 40 yards. Oh, if they could just score some touchdowns, it'd be good for that school. 20. Mariners would turn it over. Seaside comes up with a fumble here. Gabe Rose, the guy who recovers for the Breakers. And then, again, another possible play of the week coming here on the sweep for PG. Number 24, going to turn the right side and gone 64 yards. My roster doesn't have a number 24. Somebody call me and tell me who that is. Number 24 for PG. Great play. I have no 24 on my roster. PG dominated the game, but the Marina Mariners still out there trying, and I like this effort. Varo Hernandez. He's going to make some yards right there. Then Jose Marquez from Arena. They haven't won, so can't we show them making some positive plays? Huh? Feel for the Marina Mariners. They got some players. How about that? Jose Marquez going all the way. Great job, but of course, PG, they're a better team, and I think they know that. Mariners are still winless this season. PG put up 48. Josh Roman breaks loose here, 40 yards. Josh Roman, Pacific Grove Breakers, all the way down to the five. 48-6, the final for Pacific Grove. Breakers are now 4-2 on the season. Marina is 0-5. Our next stop tonight is Aptos High. Aptos Mariners taking on the Falcons from Scotts Valley. How about a big play for the Scotts Valley Falcons? To the action. Here we go. It's Ari Wargon, 55-yarder, putting his head down and not stopping. And a bit later, we're going to see Ari busted into the end zone again. Now, here's what happens at these games we go to, because one guy goes to two or three games. So he wasn't there. He was there when Scotts Valley scored these touchdowns, but he wasn't there when Aptos put up 36. And Aptos, despite what you're seeing here, is the winner over the Scotts Valley Falcons. Nice looking play there. Final score is 36-21 Aptos. Aptos High, we owe you one. Good job also by Scotts Valley. Let's go to South County. Greenfield Bruins home tonight against the King City Mustang. Buddy Sands, one of the King City's better players, taking it in for six right here. Later, Greenfield going to move the ball. But the turnover, and Chris Flores of King City is going to fall on that one. And King City would capitalize. Another touchdown a bit later for the silver and blue of King City. Luis Mendoza taking it in for six, and King City rolls over the Greenfield Bruins. 34-14 is the final in this one. First time in 5 years, King City has beaten Greenfield. King City's 3-3. Greenfield is 1-5. Okay, next. Yeah, a rare night home game for Harbor because it's homecoming. And their opponent is the Santa Cruz Cardinals. Great effort here by Harbor High's Garrett Fonseca, number 44. Can't find anybody. I'll keep it. I'll take it in. Nice effort. Garrett Fonseca, touchdown, Pirates. Told you this game was under the lights. There's the lights. Ashton Davis of Santa Cruz High. Looks like it might be a big game when he turns his direction, but this play kind of runs out of gas. I like the next play here. It's Dakota Francis, 6'4", 220-pound senior, stopping that play. Dakota Francis of the Harbor High Pirates, and they're winners. 20-6, the final in this contest. Harbor High, the Pirates, winning on homecoming night in Santa Cruz. Now, a game that I have to tell you, we arrived at late. We shot with a phone or something, but we were there. And we were there for one of the highest scoring games I've ever heard of. We got there real late. But I got to tell you, these teams put up, 65-50 is the final score. And I can tell you that not shown here, Roger Contreras for Watsonville ran for 379 yards. There was no defense of any kind, really, in this game, although you can't tell it by this. And it's Watsonville, 65-50 over North Saline. Yikes. Let's go to our next game. We had two games on Thursday night. Hang on. We're not done with Seaside and Monta Vista Christian. Two games on Thursday night. LSL home against Paro Valley. LSL quarterback Ezekiel Gonzalez on the keeper for good yardage here. It was LSL all night long. Great punt return here by Lorenzo Novoa, 45 yards all the way down to the Pajaro Valley 30-yard line. That's Lorenzo Novoa. Dallas out with another touchdown here. Gonzalez, TD pass to Saul Soto. Ezekiel Gonzalez, they call him EZ.
Touchdown!
He's making it look easy, too. Ball game decided early, 42-0 at halftime, 42-18 the final, as LSL put in their backups in the second half. LSL, fifth win of the year. They're 5-1. Pajaro Valley now 1-6. Also on Thursday night, the Alvarez Eagles took on Gilroy High. Alvarez looking for their first win of the year. Gilroy looking for win number two. Not a lot of big plays in this game, at least when we were there. Lots of turnovers and penalties. Two teams slugging it out. Nice defense. Nice defense right here. Darius Alexander of Gilroy dragging down the ball carrier. Later, we're going to see a nice, good defense from John Aguilar. And both teams showed some defense. Bottom line is 21-7, the winner here. 21-7, Gilroy over Alvarez. Gilroy's second win of the season. Now, can we go back to our top game tonight? Really, yeah, this is Monta Vista Christian and Seaside. 0-0 at halftime. I think we missed some highlights here. 0-0 at halftime. But Monta Vista Christian would score here in the third quarter. It's a great quarterback, Nick Patasevich, who gave Monta Vista Christian the lead. Seaside Spartans, though, they would come back in this ball game. And Seaside, the bottom line on this is Seaside's going to come back and win it behind their fine quarterback, Michael Turner. And they do get it done. Low-scoring game, 12-7. There's Turner hooking up. And 12-7, the final. Seaside is unbeaten at 6-0. Next week, Seaside plays at North Salinas. Monta Vista Christian plays at Pajaro Valley. Now, if you missed any of the scores or you want to vote for the play of the week for week 7, KSBW.com. We'll be back with more after this.